Early June, Trump fires off a post, says the U.S. could save billions by cutting off Elon Musk. Within days, the White House moves. Quiet emails. Urgent calls. Hello, friends. Welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're doing well. Every agency tied to the stars gets a task. Count every contract with SpaceX. Defense, NASA, Intel, everyone. They call it the scorecard. Not a joke. This wasn't just review, this was reconnaissance. They wanted to know, is Musk replaceable? Turns out, he's not. Over $20 billion in government deals, rockets, satellites, space station rides, even secret defense tech. Falcon 9 is reusable and reliable. Crew Dragon is the only American spaceship certified to fly astronauts. Starlink is beaming data to the military. Starship is running classified missions. They tried to find waste, tried to cut fat, but there was no fat, just muscle, vital muscle. Musk led Trump's government efficiency push, but then Musk slammed Trump's tax plan, took shots online, personal ones. On the 5th of June, Trump clapped back, said Musk's companies should be cut off.
Contracts. How seriously are you considering that?
We'll take a look at everything. I look at everything. He's got a lot of money. He gets a lot of subsidy. So we'll take a look at that. Only if it's fair for him and for the country, I would certainly think about it. Yeah, but it has to be.
That's when the machinery started. A top federal acquisition official sends the first email, wants numbers, wants contracts, wants competition data. Can anyone else do what SpaceX does? Cheaper, faster, better? The answer came, no. And ending those contracts isn't just costly, it's dangerous. There's no backup. SpaceX is the pipeline. Cut it and launches stop. Satellites stall. Astronauts stay grounded. SpaceX isn't slowing down. In April, they win a massive new Pentagon deal, nearly $6 billion. 28 national security launches. In May, they launch a new GPS satellite. This month, they're sending a new crew to the space station. All while the fight with Trump still smolders. Musk raises the heat. He threatens to retire Crew Dragon. NASA freaks. That's their only certified ride to orbit. Without it, America has no astronaut program. He walks it back, but the message lands. Musk has leverage. His company's too far ahead. Rivals are still stuck in testing. Delays, glitches, hardware that's not ready. SpaceX flies almost every week. Others are still drawing blueprints. The review doesn't kill the contracts. It confirms the fear. Gwynne Shotwell meets with White House officials, keeps things smooth, keeps things quiet. But the message is clear. You want space? You need us. Still, inside the government, they want a plan B, a backup rocket, a second option. But that's years away. For now, SpaceX owns the launch pad. On the other hand, there was the promise of the Golden Dome, a space-based defense shield that would hover over the Earth like a silent sentinel. And at the heart of it, there was only one name that made sense, Elon Musk. Relying on one man, no matter how visionary, to power a $175 billion shield against the next generation of missile threats suddenly felt risky. Quietly, they started looking for others, not just defense giants, but anyone with the reach, the ambition, and the tech to challenge SpaceX. Then came Project Kuiper. Amazon's low-orbit satellite venture, led by Jeff Bezos, had barely gotten off the ground. 78 satellites launched out of a planned 3,000. But the government was ready to gamble. They were inviting new players to the table, and Bezos was being courted. Bezos had once claimed Kuiper would be mostly commercial. But in defense, nothing stays commercial for long. A constellation that can beam internet can also track missile trajectories. And with Congress injecting over $13 billion into satellite-based military communications last year, up from just $900 million, the stakes had changed. Kuiper wasn't alone. The Pentagon also approached rising rocket firms like Rocket Lab and Stokespace. They wouldn't be handed the whole program, But individual launch contracts? Those were up for grabs. Bit by bit, SpaceX's slice was being nibbled away. Still, SpaceX wasn't going quietly. And while Musk publicly claimed he hadn't even bid on Golden Dome contracts, saying he'd rather focus on taking humanity to Mars, truth was more layered. Behind that statement, sources whispered a different story, that SpaceX was still the frontrunner for the most vital launch segments. But even frontrunners stumble when politics get involved. Golden Dome isn't just a technical project, it's a geopolitical gamble. Think of it as the big brother of Israel's Iron Dome, but operating in layers, with satellites acting like invisible shields above nations. The idea sounds like science fiction, but the funding, $25 billion in its first round, is very real. And it's not just Bezos stepping in. Legacy defense companies like Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and L3Harris are circling. Each has its specialty. Northrop is eyeing space-based interceptors, missiles that can strike from orbit. L3Harris is seeing a flood of interest in its missile tracking systems. Lockheed, of course, is Lockheed. Their statement was simple: we're ready. But readiness isn't enough. Trump launched Golden Dome within the first week of his second term. Space Force General Michael Guytlin confirmed on July 17th has just 30 days to build a core team, 60 days to sketch the first system, 120 days to produce a full plan. And now, as new players enter, so do new vulnerabilities. Low-orbit satellite networks, whether by SpaceX or Kuiper, are prone to jamming, hacking, and interference. Musk himself admitted last year that Russian jammers were giving Starlink a hard time. If satellites are the new shields, then cyber attacks are the new spears. On the other hand, Guytlin made it clear that the biggest hurdle isn't the tech, it's the culture. Inside the Pentagon and among private contractors, he sees siloed systems, mistrust, and resistance to change. He asked a sharp question to the crowd: how do you unite scattered systems into one synchronized shield for the homeland? Privately, aerospace giants like Northrop Grumman are already testing pieces of the puzzle. Their CEO revealed that space-based interceptors are in early testing. The U.S. isn't starting from scratch, it's already halfway there. Guytlin also said that Russia and China are building missiles that fly over 6,000 miles an hour and change direction mid-air. They've even launched devices that behave like satellites but could strike anywhere on Earth without warning. These aren't hypotheticals, these are active threats, moving fast. So Golden Dome might be America's only shot at catching up and maybe even taking the lead. But that race isn't just about tech, it's about speed, trust, and industrial power. Can they do it without SpaceX? And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.